Well, thank you very much. It's a great thrill and a fantastic opportunity to see me in person again, lady. It's a pleasure to be with Elizabeth Montgomery on the same show. She's a fantastic personality. And it's not every day that a girl introduces me. I'm accustomed to men introducing me. I never saw a girl who actually hosts her own show. Only last week, a man was introducing me. Didn't look like her at all. Didn't even walk like her. Came out on the stage and said, good evening. Evening, ladies and gentlemen, what about here? I shouldn't make fun of Ed Sullivan. We're very good friends now. We always got along very well. Not on his show, but we got along. These are the jokes, mister. So far, you're looking at me like you're waiting for a comedian to show up. Don't get nervous. I start slow. This is not my act yet. Next. Trying to pick out the better side. I don't care if I do good or not. I found out that in this business, you don't do so hot, you run for office. Especially in California. George Murphy couldn't get a job as a dancer. Ronald Reagan couldn't get too many jobs lately in the movies. You notice it? Running for governor. Watch me. One bad show, I'm a president. Now, this is the most fantastic thing. You could run for political office. Mister, listen to this. You look to me like you're going to get very excited about this whole thing. You could run for political office without any qualification. Do you know that? Mister? You know anything at all that I'm talking about? In any other field, let's assume you want to become a doctor. You have to go to college. You know that to become a congressman, you don't have to go to college? Mister? Don't you know anything by yourself? To become a congressman, you don't have to go to college. A doctor, you do. Even a football player has to go to college. A congressman doesn't. That's why we have such great football players in this country and such bad congressmen. Thanks a lot. I think I'll wait. I'll listen. This is very interesting. Not to you, but it's very interesting to me how you, in political business, everybody is ashamed to admit that they're running. I don't know if you notice it. Let's assume a man wants to be president. The first thing he does is announce, hello, I'm not available. He denies it, and then he runs. This is the only business in the world where you deny it and run. I'm talking to you, mister. Let's assume a man wants to be a plumber. Would he deny it? You ever see a plumber knock on the door and say, I don't want the job. Maybe you got it. He admits it. But if a guy wants to be a president, he's ashamed. You know why he's ashamed? Because they know that deep in their hearts, they should be plumbers. I don't want to. Thanks a lot. I don't want to pick on any individual. Well, take a look at a man like Governor Romney. He's running around the whole country just to deny that he's running for office. And he's stopping each person personally. Hello, I don't want the job. He even went on television last week just to deny it. They said to him, do you want to be a president? He said, me? I never would think of it. Me, a president? He said, of course, if the country calls, that's another story. How does a guy know if the country calls? What do? You call up your office and say, hello, you got a call from the country? I can't figure it out. Take a look at Nixon. Mister. Next. He knows what's happening with Richard Nixon. He's been running so long, he forgot what he's running for. Every time you look at him, he's running for something. He sees you running, he runs with you. He don't know for what. And the more he runs, the more he denies it. He just made a statement last week. Me, he says, I am not running this time for the presidency. I made up my mind. I'm not running. I'm not even considering it. No matter what happens, I will not even accept it. And that's final. Then he said that if I'm elected. Take a look at Bobby Kennedy. You see, he, I know, is an honest man. If he says he's not running, I believe him. Any man that'll climb a mountain in the middle of the night and announce from the top of the mountain, hello, I don't want the job, with 5,000 people taking pictures. I know he means it. That statement took 2 minutes to make. It took him 6 days to stay there. He was waiting for an answer. That's the whole joke, mister. Come here, you sit with this guy. Then keep all the stiffs on one chair. You understand what I'm trying to bring out? I'm not saying this to make fun of Richard Nixon or anybody. I'd never make fun of the politicians of this country, especially a man like Nixon, who is dedicating his life to this country. Nobody works harder than Nixon. I don't know if you read that he's the hottest candidate right now for the Republican Party. Did you read about it? He got there from losing elections. The more he loses, the bigger he gets. When he ran for the presidency and he lost, they said he was finished. But when he ran for the governorship of California and he lost, they say, ha-ha, that's the man. I'll explain the whole thing to you. You're lucky I'm not busy. You see, the reason the Republicans want him is they figure if a winner loses, it's embarrassing. But if he loses, they'll say, so what? We expect it. Get out. You know, you want me to tell you the truth? I don't even appreciate this kind of material because I can't stand people who make fun of the politicians of this country. They work harder than anybody in America, and they sacrifice themselves for this country. They're dedicated to this country. What right does anybody have to make fun of the political leaders of our nation? Get out! That's right. You know what problems they have to solve all over the world? Just the threat of population. The overpopulation problem in America today is fantastic. Do you know that right now, Mr. Oh, I think they're telling me I'm finished. I'm not going to start another issue. I better go home. Last time I went like this, they went like that. It was all right. Ladies and gentlemen, I have to leave. I do have another show anyway in January. And even that one is indefinite. Incidentally, if any of you would like to see me on the Milton Berle show next month, write to him. Tell him about it. Thank you very much.